In this video, we're going to be replacing the fuel injectors in this Chevrolet Cavalier 98. It also is the same for any Pontiac Sunfire with the 2.2 liter engine in it. So let's start by taking this intake snorkel off, or hose, whatever you want to call it. The clamp on each side. Disconnect the intake air temperature sensor. In this next step, we're going to take off this, they call it a resonator, right here. And the way you do that is if you go in the back and look, let's see if I can get it to show up here. There is a hose clamp right there. That little screw is the hose clamp that holds this resonator to the throttle body. So we're going to go back there, loosen that, and then we should be able to pull this resonator off. Oh, there's also a bolt right here that holds it down. 10 millimeter. Also disconnect this PCV hose right here. So now we have this black plate here covering the fuel rail, and it looks like it's just two nuts on these studs that hold it in. I think these are 13s. There's also two nuts back here, I just noticed. I think they're 10 millimeters. Oh, three nuts. There's three nuts back here. What we're going to do now is we need to relieve the fuel pressure before we open it up, because it's at very high pressure and it could be dangerous. So we go out under the hood and we look for fuel pump. We're going to take out the fuel pump relay so that the car cannot start. First we're going to do this, then we're going to attempt to start the car. And it might start for a couple seconds and then die out, but what this will do is it will get rid of the residual fuel pressure inside the system. Now we're going to start the car, and it either won't start or it'll start for a little bit and then die. There. Now the fuel pressure is relieved and we can open the system safely. Next, we need to remove this fuel rail. And to do that, there are two brackets here connecting the fuel rail to the engine. And if you follow them back, you can't really see, but there's a fastener right on this side of the bracket. Is a bolt right here, and there's one on the other side that we need to take off, and they feel like 10 millimeters. Should just come up.
Might be stuck in there a little bit. There we go.
Now in the back of each fuel injector, there's an electrical connector which we need to unplug and a clip that holds it to the fuel rail. And I'm just going to replace them one at a time. Just pry the clip with a flathead screwdriver to get it out of there. That's one. Make sure that the O-ring is not still inside of the rail, which in this case it is. There's the O-ring. Here's the new one. It would be best to lubricate these with gas or something to help them slide in better. Okay, just do the same thing for the rest, for the other three, and that's it.
We have to put the clip on.
Okay, now that the new injectors are on the fuel rail, and they're all clipped on and plugged in, all we have to do is put them back into the engine and re-bolt it on. Now we put the plate back on. So this part's important. What likely is probably happened is for you is this rubber piece around the throttle body stayed on it. Now what you want to do, and this is in bad shape, what you want to do is you want to make sure that this resonator goes in through all the grooves around this rubber seal and then put this on the throttle body. It's a huge pain in the ass if you leave this rubber thing on the throttle body and try to smash this down. It's never going to work. Take it off, put it on this, and then put this whole thing back on the throttle body. Put your hose on before you bolt this in place. Okay, now for the snorkel. Plug in your intake air temp sensor. You don't want to check engine light. Can't forget to put a fuel pump relay back in. Okay, that's all there is. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe if this video was helpful. See you later.